that you can read the Psalms from your own homes. And it says like this: shout for joy to God, all the earth. Sing the glory of his name. Give to him glorious praise. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. So great is your power that your enemies come clinging to you. All the earth worship you and sings praises to you. They sing praises to your name. Come and see what God has done. He is awesome in his deeds toward the children of man. He turned the sea into dry land. They passed through the river of food. There did we rejoice in him who rules by his might forever, whose eyes keep watch on the nations. Let not the rebellious exalt themselves. Bless our God of peoples. Let the sound of his praise be heard, who has kept your soul among the living and has not let our feet slip. For you, O God, have tested us. You have tried us as silver is tried. You brought us into the net. You laid a crushing burden on your backs. You let men ride over our heads. We went through fire and through water. Yet you have brought us out to the place of abundance. I will come into your house with burnt offerings. I will perform my boast to you, that which my lips uttered, and my mouth promised when I was in trouble. I will offer to you burnt offerings of fattened animals with the smoke of the sacrifice of rams. I will make an offering of bulls and goats. Come and hear, all you who fear God, and I will tell what he has done for my soul. I cried out to him with my mouth, and high praise was on my tongue. If I had, a cherished iniquity in my heart, the Lord would not have listened. But truly, God has listened. He has attended to the voice of my prayer. Blessed be God, because he has not rejected my prayer or removed his steadfast love from me. Amen. So this is a beautiful Psalms which speaks about the reasons of the worship. Amen. So, you know the 20th verse says that, blessed be God, because he has not rejected my prayer or removed his steadfast love from me. Amen. So this morning, as we are gathering together, we have many reasons and many reasons to worship the Lord. Amen. Psalms is a reasons, full of reasons to worship God. There are many reasons. There are many reasons to praise the name of the Lord. Okay, so, and at last, the psalmist says that, blessed be God, because he has not rejected my prayer. We prayed for many prayer requests, and we prayed for, we have prayed many things, and God has done the miracles in the life of the people of God. So that's the reason that we are worshiping this morning in truth and spirit. Hallelujah. So let us all join together in prayer. Let us all, bring also with the mighty hand of God, so that this morning God is going to bless every one of us, and God is going to speak to us. Amen. So let's all join together. Let's all close our eyes in the presence of God and let us pray. Hallelujah. Praise God. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful morning time of God. We thank you for bringing us together in the presence of God to worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for giving all the blessings upon us, God, in the past days, Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we are nothing in front of you, Lord, this morning. Lord, as we are coming to your presence and looking unto you, Lord, we come to your presence with an empty heart, and Lord, we pray that, Lord, fill us with your power, fill us with your spirit, and fill us with your grace, oh God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for all the blessings that we have received from you in the past days, Lord. Hallelujah. And this morning we understand it was only because of the grace of God, it was only because of the faithfulness of God, it was only because of the love of God that we are surviving in this wretched world, oh God. Hallelujah. As Lord, we understand this world is not suitable for the people of God. This world is not suitable for the children of God, but we thank you for enabling every one of us to survive in this world, oh God. Hallelujah. This morning, Lord, we thank you for giving all the blessings upon every family, so God. We thank you for protecting every one of them, oh God. We thank you for giving and providing all the provisions upon every person, oh God. Hallelujah. Just we remember your grace upon us, oh God. We remember your faithfulness upon us, oh God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, there are many people going through the struggles in this place, oh Lord. Hallelujah. Even though, Lord, we thank you for the strength that you have given to us, oh God. We thank you for the power and the presence of God which you have provided for us, oh God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, this morning we believe that your presence is in the midst of God. Hallelujah. We thank you for the promise of God that, wherever you gather in my name, I will be in the midst of the people of God. This morning, Lord, we understand and we experience, we feel the presence of God in the midst of God. Hallelujah. We commit ourselves in the mighty hand of God. We pray for the servant of God whom you anointed already to speak the word of God this morning, oh God. Bless him, oh Lord. Anoint him, oh God. Strengthen him, oh God. Hallelujah. So that as we are listening the word of God, let us be edified by the word of God and encouraged by the word of God this morning, oh God. Hallelujah. We pray for the worship team also. Bless them abundantly, oh Lord, so that they may be leading this service in a wonderful manner, the praise and worship and everything, oh Lord. Hallelujah. We bring everything in the mighty hand of God this morning. Once again, we thank you and we submit ourselves in the mighty hand of God. Thank you for hearing a prayer, oh God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. So let us all join together in praising the name of the Lord. David's team is going to lead the praise and worship. Let us all join together and praise the name of the Lord this morning.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Welcome to another Sunday morning worship service. It's a blessing that God has brought us together once again to worship him and to hear from him. And it's only by God's grace that and his faithfulness that we have come through all the trials of another week. And so with that, we must honor him and worship him for all the things that he has done for us. And our God is a faithful God, and he's faithful to us even when we are not faithful to him. In Psalm 119:89-90 says, "Forever, O Lord, your word is firmly fixed in the heavens. Your faithfulness endures throughout all generations. You have established the earth, it stands fast." And God's faithfulness goes beyond anything we can imagine, and we know that with this knowledge that there's nothing that can take us away from the love of Jesus Christ and the promises that he has given to us. And so with this assurance, with this knowledge, we have to worship him. And so today, as we sing our songs, let's clear our minds and let's focus on what God has done for us, and let's worship him in spirit and in truth.
Dissolve.
Judgment and how the books will be opened on the last day. And this reminds us that we must be prepared. It reminds us to keep our eyes focused on things above. The Bible teaches us to keep our minds fixed on things above and not on earthly things. So as we sing this song, we can be reminded of God's command to us that this earth is not our home and our final destination is heaven. And so everything we do on earth should be in preparation for what is to come. So as we sing this song, let's worship in spirit and truth, and let's remind ourselves of what God has told us to do.
Yeshua, give us.
Our speaker, Lord, and that you would bless every other aspect and program in this service, oh God. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.